minks are endangered. Their biggest threat is poaching. There are only 1,000 left. And if they become extinct, the ecosystem in the Danube Delta will become very damaged. Since this is a classification problem, we use an image recognition model. Naturally, it is similar to the KNN model. We will run the images the camera gets through our database, and if it finds a match, the user will be alerted. Here we have a demo video, and I'll run you through it. So this is what the camera sees right now. It just detected the heat signatures and it's tracking it. The line at the bottom represents the area it's not supposed to go in. Now the tracker turned red. As you can see, the AI detected that someone is inside, and the user now sees this, sees a human, and alerts the authorities.
What AI will solve in your problem, and how it will solve this problem?
In the areas where we will have the cameras, there are supposed to be no humans whatsoever, none. So if there are any, it means they're a poacher, or even if they aren't, they're not supposed to be there and should be taken away.
But you were very clear about what the building blocks were on the sequence.
Firstly, we need to train the AI to recognize fires. Next, find areas where bees lived or where they could be located from polluted dangerous areas. Then we calculate the approximate number of saved bees by our invention and take measures to preserve the bee pollutions.
I saw in your presentation you showed that you will classify the image, then give it to the decision tree, and then get an answer, use a machine learning algorithm, and get the final prediction. How that system work?
You were systematic about how you would collect data. You had an explicit link to the Sustainable Development Goals.
The program of artificial intelligence will assist us in comprehending which data values have a positive effect on the species population, looking for possible locations in the country which might fulfill the geographical requirements and therefore favor the thriving of the particular species, inserting the data for its location so that the neuronic network can pick up the best location for the construction of a park.
So our main goal is, of course, saving millions of animals, preventing fires that would cause damage to our environment, also cause damage that we would have to financially fix.
We're going to use the method of categorization to help sort out different species, and then to analyze how many types and what types of species there are, in particular migratory bats.
As you can see in our graph, the poacher comes to the camera detects it, and the camera sends the data to the network in the background, and the network produces the data and identifies the points to send the data to the loudspeakers, and the loudspeakers will get the and the loudspeakers will emit gun sounds, the bullet sounds, to scare off the animals and move them away from the poachers.
I would like to ask, how would AI identify poachers from normal people?
Yeah, great clarity on the problem. I think you recognized that image recognition would be useful, and there was a very good breakdown of the hardware on the software side of it. So that would certainly attract funding from an organization maybe like the World Wildlife Fund. All right, that was absolutely brilliant. I love it. So the winner is Jeffrey Hinton, princess. Entrepreneur, scientist, mathematician.
Yay!